This is part one of a series on frequency response. In this video, you'll gain a basic understanding of what frequency response is and why it's important. But if you're new to this channel, welcome. My name is Kyle. If you want to learn audio production online, subscribe to Audio University. The frequency response of a speaker, a microphone, a pair of headphones, or any other audio device describes how that device responds to various audio frequencies. In other words, frequency response describes the effect a device has on the frequency balance of signals passing through it. Let's take a look at a simple example to understand what this means. This is a parametric equalizer. It shows frequency on the x-axis, lowest frequencies on the left, highest frequencies on the right. The level of each frequency is shown on the y-axis, lowest level at the bottom, highest level at the top. A straight line from left to right tells us that this EQ will not have an effect on the frequency balance of signals passing through it. As a signal passes from the input of the EQ to the output of the EQ, the balance of frequencies won't be affected. Therefore, this EQ has a flat frequency response. If the equalizer is set like this, with a dip in the mid frequencies, it has a different frequency response. Now, as a signal passes from the input to the output of the EQ, some mid-frequency energy will be lost. The EQ can also be set to boost mid-frequencies. A signal passing through this EQ will have more mid-frequency energy at the output than it had at the input. Every piece of audio equipment has a frequency response, not just equalizers. Some devices are designed to be as transparent as possible, aiming for a flat frequency response. This is the case for many mixing consoles and studio reference monitors, because you generally want the signal that comes out of these devices to faithfully represent the signal that went into them. Other devices are designed with a frequency response tailored to a specific application. For example, the frequency response of the Shure Beta 52 microphone is specifically engineered for recording kick drum. It intentionally overrepresents some frequencies while underrepresenting others. In the next video, you'll learn how to interpret and compare the frequency response specifications for various devices. You can watch that video now by clicking the link on your screen. If you got value out of this video, hit the like button. To see more content like this, subscribe to Audio University and check out the website at audiouniversityonline.com. Thanks for watching.